Hello students, good morning. As we have already started a topic, application of derivative part 3. In this chapter, we have already learned how to find out the absolute maximum and minimum value when a closed interval is given there. Now today we will learn how to find out the local maximum and minimum value for a first derivative test. There are some working rule, if we follow that, then this topic will be more clear to you. Step number 1. Write the given function with its domain. Domain means whatever interval is given there, write the value with the same thing. Step number 2. Find the differentiation and it will be represented as f dash x. Then we will find out the critical point. Critical point means the value of x solution set by putting f dash x is equal to 0. Now put any point nearest to the critical point. Let us suppose if we are having a point 3. In local maxima and minima, we will not put exact the value of 3 there. We will put near the value 3. You can say nearest to the 3. It may be 2. Nearest to the 3, it may be 4. And you have to find out the different sign. If you put the value less than to the nearest value, it will be give you a negative result. And if you put value more than to the given value, it will be give you the positive result. Then you will have x values minus 2 positive. It will varies from minus 2 positive. If it varies from minus 2 positive, that means local minimum value is there. And if the value of x varies from positive to negative, the local maximum value is there. But if we are having a positive to positive value and negative to negative value, there will be no change. No change means inflection point is there. Clear? Now, let's take one or two examples for more understanding. Find the points of local maxima and minima. If any fx, now function is given to you. And here written that using first derivative test. It will be given you hint that you have to differentiate only one time. Find local maxima and local minima. According to the steps, first we will write down fx. Fx is equal to 2x cube minus 6x square plus 6x plus 5. We will differentiate the value and represent it as a f dash x. F dash x is equal to 6x square minus 12x plus 6. According to the third step, we will put the value is equal to 0. And then we will find out the value of x. We can take 6 as a common factor. X square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. When we using the sum product method, we are having the different values of x. It will be equal to x minus 1. X minus 1 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 1. Because no domain is given there, no interval is given there, that's why function belongs to the real number. And 1 is also belongs to the real number. Clear? Then, so possible points are for local maxima and local minimum value is only 1 there. Now, because local maxima and local minimum value is there, so we will put the nearest value, not an exact value. For x, slightly less than 1. If we put the value less than 1, that means we can put the value 0 there, x is equal to 0. If we put the value x is equal to 0, then in f dash x, when we put the value in f dash x, that is slightly less than 0, so f dash x is there. When you put the value here, so 0, 0 plus 6, it means which sign you are having here? You are having here positive sign. It means first is also the positive result. Then you also having the positive result. तो फाइनल आंसर इज ऑफ द पॉजिटिव. फॉर एक्स स्लाइटली मोर देन द वैल्यू वन देयर, नाउ यू विल पुट द वैल्यू एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू. वेन यू पुट द वैल्यू एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू देयर, दैट मीन्स एफ डैश एक्स इज देयर. अगेन यू आर हैविंग द पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट. वेन वैल्यू मूव्स फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव टू पॉजिटिव, इट मीन्स बाय फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव टेस्ट एफ एक्स हैज नाइदर लोकल मैक्सिमम नोर लोकल मिनिमम वैल्यू. नो डाउट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू साइन फॉर द एफ डैश एक्स, बट वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू फॉर एफ एक्स. दैट मीन्स एफ डैश एक्स मूव्स फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव टू पॉजिटिव, तो विच पॉइंट इज देयर? इन्फ्लेक्शन पॉइंट इज देयर. क्लियर? बट बिकॉज पॉजिटिव टू पॉजिटिव पॉइंट इज देयर इन्फ्लेक्शन पॉइंट, तो देयर इज नो मैक्सिमम और नॉट एनी लोकल मिनिमम वैल्यू इज देयर. वेन एवर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू वी कैन पुट द वैल्यू इन एफ एक्स. क्लियर? फॉर इन्फ्लेक्शन पॉइंट वी विल नॉट पुट वैल्यू हियर. क्लियर? नाउ आई एम टेकिंग वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. फाइंड द पॉइंट्स ऑफ लोकल मैक्सिमा एंड लोकल मिनिमा इफ एफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू 3x, x plus 1 raised to power 2 by 3 on close interval minus 2 comma 2 using the first derivative test. Now fx is equal to, value is given to you, interval is given to you. First step you will differentiate the value, then f dash x is equal to 2, 3, power will come forward into 2 upon 3, 3 se 3 cancel, 2x will be there. x plus 1 raised to power 2 by 3 minus 1 plus, because two functions are there, one function and the second function. First function as it is, differentiation of the second function, second function as it is, and what is the differentiation of the first function, that is 3 there. Clear? So it will be equal to 2x, x plus 1 raised to power minus 1 by 3 plus 3 into x plus 1 raised to power 2 by 3. When we solve the value, it will be equal to 2x, x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3, plus 3 into x plus 1 raised to power 2 by 3, by taking the LCM there. Now look here, when we take the LCM, to LCM will be equal to x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3. Now, by the cross multiply, for the LCM case, x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3. By taking LCM, power will be equal to 1 there. That's why I have written here x plus 1 only. Is it clear to you people? Yeah. 2x plus 3 into x plus 1 is there. So x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 there. As for the next step, we will put the value 0 there. 5x plus 3 upon x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3. When we solve the equation, value will be equal to minus 3 by 5, which belongs to the value minus 2 and 2 for the close interval. But here is one more case there. Listen that very carefully. Because we have to choose all the values in between minus 2 and 2. In between minus 2 and 2. That means we can choose the value minus 1 also there. But we will not choose the value minus 1 there. Why? Because if we choose the value minus 1 here, so this property, this value will give you the 0 result. Clear? So this value will never be equal to 0. Okay? That means x plus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 is not equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, so f dash x to not defined case is there. And we have to find out for local maxima and minima. Therefore, f dash x is not defined for the value x is equal to minus 1. Therefore, possible points are minus 3 by 5 and minus 1. We will put the value nearest minus 1, but we will not put the value minus 1. Clear? Next step. When we put the values nearest to the minus 3 by 5, then when we put the value in f dash x there, so according to f dash x value, your f dash x value is this one, 2x. when you put the value minus 3 by 5 here, so first will be you will get the result. You can put here also, you can put here also. You will get the result minus and positive sign. Negative and positive sign. It means the final result is negative there. When you put the slightly more than minus 3 by 5, more than minus 3 by 5, slightly more than, it means both are having the positive result. Positive answer is there. Values move from negative to positive. When value moves from negative to positive, that is the value for the minimum value. And we have to find out the minimum value. When we have to find out the minimum value, we will put that value in fx. When we put the value in fx there, we put the value here. When we put the value minus 3 by 5 here, we will find out one result there. That is the minus 9 by 5 into 2 by 5 raised to power 2 by 3. Same case, when we take the value x slightly less than minus 1. We will not take minus 1 exactly. We will take the value slightly less than minus 1 and slightly more than minus 1. And we put the value first in f dash x. So f dash x is negative and negative result. Negative, negative cancel and we will get the positive result here. When we put the value x slightly more than minus 1, so f dash x will be equal to negative upon positive, so negative result is there. Now x values move from positive to negative. When move from positive to negative, that means the local maximum value is there. Minimum local minimum at minus 3 by 5 and local maximum at value minus 1. And what is the local maximum value? You put that value in fx. When you put the value in fx, when you put value here, then you will get the result minus 1. When you put here, so it will give you 0. The full value will be give you the 0 result. Now, I hope this concept will be clear to you people. You will receive one link related to this topic. Go through that link also. Do more and more practice. I hope you will do. Thank you.